was important in transforming Art Deco from purely a craft movement into a proper artistic movement. And I think really the Russians should be very proud of him.
Работах Латри очень привлекает некоторая легкость и элегантность его линий.
И он одним из первых внес линию персидской миниатюры и вообще восточного искусства в это арт-деко.
А это были очень видные деятели Серебряного века.
All movements of art, there is always a link. And to my mind, the Latri pictures are that link between the 19th century and the 20th century movement.
We all know he was Ozarsky's grandson, and it's almost always kind of the first fact about Latri that people learn. Perhaps his influence was precisely in that Latri did not imitate or copy him.
In Russia, they know about his work before he left Russia. A very good collection, of course, in the Ozarsky Museum in Feodosia, where he was director. They got a lot of his ceramics. They were highly recognized in about 1910 in Russia. They were regarded as important.
Any artist who left Russia during the revolution was little known and little studied in Russia. And it's taken a while for the Russians who grew up in Soviet times to learn about the emigre artist. So it is an area of particularly strong value.
We see that a lot in Russian art. They had lost their audience. They had lost the people who they were painting for. And suddenly, in a new world, and with very little means, very little money, they had to support themselves and also try and establish a new audience.
Then he moved to Greece and had a studio in Athens and had a very interesting series of paintings in the Piraeus, the port of Athens.
Line, the feel of the hulls of the ships in those Greek harbours. My feel from them is one of optimism.
Then he went to Paris, and of course his style, you know, the freedom and the light in Paris, with all the other Russians, so huge numbers of Russian artists in Paris, 70,000 emigres.
Стремление к красоте вывело русскую культуру на мировой уровень.
His work was essentially decorative. A lot of it was painting for panels and for boxes and screens and things of that sort.
He was very closely involved with all the artists who stars of the Diaghilev movement and the Ballet Russe.
The stranglehold that religion had had on art was completely gone, and scientific ideas were creeping in and with cubism, and that was frightening some people. So there was a kind of romantic backlash, and Latri very much fitted in with that, with the romance.
Но что интересно, что тогда образовалась группа русских художников. Это были художник Жорж Лавров, Латри был из них самым старшим, и Тамара Лемпика, просто символом ар-деко.
More than paintings, they're like picture puzzles who carry a high level of symbolism.
Certainly, I would anticipate very strong rise for Latri and for other emigre artists whose prices have not risen the way Russian artists who stayed in the Soviet Union have risen. Emigre art in general is one of the best value areas of the market.
This exhibition is essentially for members of the Savile Club, who are people of great creative ability, lots of Nobel Prize winners, scientists, literary people, journalists, theatre people.
I think the Savile Club is indeed a perfect setting for the Latri exhibition because he was a polymath. His skills came in all sorts of directions, not just painting. He was a man of many parts. And that is exactly what the Savile is. We have people from all parts of the arts. We have businessmen, we have lawyers, we have all manner of men. You couldn't get anything more eclectic than that.
Это удивительно тонкий художник и красивый, изысканный художник. И на него просто приятно смотреть.
A marvelous person in himself as well as an extraordinary creative artist.